Watch out for the Abijan Media Team Deep Spiritual Shelf with the Abijan of the Last Covenant.
My lovely viewers, you are welcome to this episode of Astral Wars Against Eight Men, Part 17. And I will be discussing briefly with us this moment on weakening devices of darkness, number one. Astral Wars Against Eight Men, Part 17, weakening devices of darkness, number one. Let us pray. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we come to you. We come pleading that your mighty spirit will strengthen us, quicken us, remove from us all iota of weaknesses. Let your spirit grant us excellence in the realms of your light and cause us to be steadfast to uphold the standard of the Holy Spirit so that we will move forward on the path of light, on the path of divine ascent, and be channels also for the rise of others on the same path. This we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Viewers, this is Astral Wars Against Eight Men. And when we talk about weakening devices of darkness, we are talking about strategy of warfare. This message may be brief, but I want you to listen to this message as a believer. Every believer is in a warfare. And when you are fighting a war, you don't expect your enemy not to fold his hands. The enemy has to come out and also fight back. When you pray in the name of the Lord, when you take a stand in the name of the Lord in light, you are setting different units and chambers and strongholds of the astral forces in disarray, in confusion. You are lifting up a standard by which they will remain bamboozled. And do you expect them to fold their hands? This is already known for ages. That is why they launch back. There's a particular attack that comes from astral forces. They are not doing it because they wanted this person to go to hell or this. No, no, no. You want to go to heaven? I'm talking from their own point of view now. Okay, don't worry. Live your righteous life. Go to heaven. But don't disturb us here on earth. That is the game plan. And this game plan means that if in a city you have, let us say, in a city of 2 million people, for instance, or like let us Lagos State in Nigeria, we have I think about 24 million people in Lagos, or even possibly more. Now, in a city of such magnitude, of up to 24 million people in one city, you now have people that say, "Are you a believer?" I say, "How many believers are in this city? How many believers? If believers are to raise their hands, or raise their hand, or raise their hand, you can count up to 15 million people as believers." What do you think will happen in that city if those 15 million people continue daily to radiate the light of the Almighty? Those 15 million people will be enough to vanquish all the hosts of darkness, even in a continent, even in our planet. And the hosts of darkness, they know. So what they do is, if it is a small city, let's say a small city of 1 million people, and in that small city, you have about, let's say 400,000 people that could raise their hands and say, each can say, "I'm a believer." What the hosts of darkness do is to launch weakening devices against the ones among them that have the capacity of transmitting light. Because when you are praying, and praising the Almighty God, creator of the heavens and the earth, maker of the sun, the moon, and the stars, sustainer of all that is, you are radiating the light of God. And the light goes into the entire ecosystem, into diverse units of the ecosystems of our world. This light subjugates the hosts of darkness in different ways. They don't want that light. They don't want that light. What did they do as a counter-attack, the astral attack against that light? Is to launch the weakening device. Foremost among the weakening devices is what we call sleep wave. Sleep wave. Now, sleep wave is launched every day. Every day, every early hours of the every as far as we pass 12 midnight, in every part of this world, sleep wave begin to go forth. After some time, begin to go forth. And it is like a program something. If the sleep wave sees that this person is prayerful, this man here is prayerful, radiating the light, the sleep wave will go, continue to hover. Any small weakness, it enters. The sleep wave is to reduce the prayer potency of that man. The sleep wave, when sleep wave goes out, what attracts it is something, it is attracted. It's not a weak believer. A weak believer, already a weak believer, that is debased as far as weakness in the spirit is concerned, does not attract sleep wave. It's already captured within the phantasmagory of sleep wave. It's already like a defeated person. As far as I'm talking in terms of prayer aspect. But when the sleep wave is launched, it goes around. It goes. It seeks for where light is radiated, the human being that is radiating light through prayers and praise, pam, that is where it will continue to strike. If there's any opportunity to enter, then weakness will begin to come. So the plan of darkness is that in a city of 400 believers, if it is possible, let them reduce them all to the point that even not up to 100 believers or 200 believers will radiate that light. If it is possible, let them not even know no one radiate that light, because that light is what bamboozles the network of darkness. What I'm telling you is a secret format of attack, and this attack goes on daily in different jurisdictions. You see, so you must be aware of sleep wave. You must be very, very careful of sleep wave. Some people used to ask me. Habinja, people have asked these questions. When is the right time to pray? You know, sometimes, you know, people suggest to me, is it 12 o'clock in the midnight, this 3 a.m.? All these periods are very important time to pray. You know, early hours of the day, very important time. But I tell everybody, and I tell you now, if you are a believer and listening to me, the best time for you to pray is when you are weak to pray.
Watch out for the Abijan Media Team Deep Spiritual Shelf with the Abijan of the Last Covenant.
The moment you are weak to pray, something has started. That then is the best time to pray. To send back that sleep wave that has come into your microcosm, into the orbit of your being. Let it not radiate. Because when it starts radiating, it radiates at different stages. Different stages. That's the stage it will radiate to. You become a captive. We are praying one day. I can ask 7 pastors to pray, and one of them was the general overseer of a church. And he's a well-respected man. You know, they came to my house, we were praying, but I discovered that each time we want to pray, this general overseer will take whenever he's coming for the prayer, he will wear big agbada. Anyway, you know, he's a big man. Big man wears big cloth. Not small boys like us that wear this kind of artists. Big men, you know, they wear big cloth. So when he came, he just so as prayer will be going on, I noticed that this man is under sleep wave, because as we pray, you know, as a man of God, you know, he will bring that agbada. Agbada is a kind of cloth in Nigeria. When you wear this kind of thing inside, you wear another big one. You see, if you watch our programs, if you're outside the country, see African leaders, like Nigerian leaders, watch our senators and honorables in the house, you know, sometimes they wear that big agbada. So with that big agbada, the other one that is on top of this kind of it, you can pull it off. So the general overseer, the big man of the church, will now raise this thing up and use it to cover his head. Cover, he'll be inside that agbada line. So why inside the agbada now? Everybody will think that it's praying, because don't expect a jiru overseer to be inside the agbada. He's communicating with the Almighty there. But I knew that this man is sleeping there. He's not communicating with anything. I knew. So, but not to disgrace him, as we pray, I'll go around him, I'll hit him. If I hit him, I will shout, kakam, shapakam, arachim. I know. For where? That is just sleeping. The man is sleeping there. Sleep wave has captured the man. It took us time. On the seventh day, because that was a prayer fast that we got organized, and it was night vigil, which I organized. On the seventh day, you know, when he started sleeping, I didn't wake him up again. Then we finished prayer, I finished ministering in my house there. I told everybody there. Even there were some other general overseers and senior ministers that said they should not touch this man. They should leave him. Because discipline before deliverance. For as long as he continues to deceive himself, and when you hit him, he will speak in tongues, he will look as if, oh, he's praying. Leave him. So as we left him, the man started snoring. So it became obvious to everyone that this general overseer is just sleeping there. So that was when I now went and hit him. Bam! He woke up and said, Shaka Paramara. I said, man of God, sorry, we have finished with prayer. He said, my brothers, please, you people should pray for me. Harbinger, please pray for me. I said, yes, it is now you are qualified to be taken away, removed from that manipulation. Because the truth is that for as long as he continue to live like that, people will think that he's praying, but he's under the captivity. The man is a good man. Eh? Because he's a prayer warrior. He has something in him to fight darkness. But that is why darkness puts him in that weakness. And I have encountered a lot of people in this manipulation. You see, there was a man of God that came to me. And he told me that he has come for deliverance. From a deep, you see, whenever he wants to pray, sleep will come. Have you ask yourself, even as you are listening to me now, have you not seen some people that when it is time, when ministration is going on in different congregations of the believers, in different places where the word of God and prayers are going, you see them sleeping. As long as everything is finished, the prayer is finished, you see them, they become very strong. The sleep will run away. Because the thing doesn't want, if they want to drive their car, fly aeroplane, no problem. But as long as it's time to pray, that's when the sleep will come. So fight against that. And I pray that you be delivered from such manipulation from this moment. As you watch this program, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because right now, as I am speaking to you, you see, like I said, this man of God came. What brought him was, he had been rigmaroling in the illusion of this aggrandizement of sleep waves for long. So he used his mouth to confess to me. He said, look, it came to a point that any time I kneel down to pray, heavy sleep will come, and as the sleep come, I will start seeing things like as if I'm seeing one kind of dream. He said, one day I was trying to pray, and I saw fowl, like a small dream. I saw a fowl passing. Instead of me to pray, and I found myself saying, where is this fowl going to? So I want to pray, and what I'm discussing is where is fowl going to? He said, no. I have to meet with the harbinger of the last covenant. That was how the man came and got his freedom by the Spirit of the Lord. And the worst part of what I'm telling you now is that there was also a man that came, you know, to me, a man of God, a good man. I told you, sleep wave attack only people who have the capacity to destroy certain network of darkness. So the sleep wave is sent to them so that capacity will not be activated, so that capacity will remain in a potential state, will not come into limelight. That is the thing. You see, let me tell you, in this world, there are so many people that you hear them say, men of God, and they don't pray in their houses. So some of them claim they are big men. When they go, they just forget about it. I am telling you this, we have to stop that. Be prayerful. This man of God came to me, he's in need, that's a habit of the covenant. Pray for me. I want divine empowerment, because even in my, I have been so tormented in my prayer life that I even have spoken ill against the Lord. I said, what? He said, yes. He said, one day. He said, every time I want to pray, sleep will come. I will sleep, be on my knee. Everybody will think I'm praying. I will be on my knee 3 hours. I have not spoken any word for any reasonable word for 5 minutes. He said, it happened one day that I was fighting against this. Then I bind anything coming to God. I want to bind any power that's fighting against me. But as it was, I bind Jesus. The man found himself binding Jesus. Huh? A man of God said, I bind Jesus under the illusion, under the phantasmagoria of sleep wave. The man woke up and said, no, this cannot be. That was how he came. And the Lord delivered him. And the Lord empowered him. And he became strengthened. Our Lord Jesus Christ said in the book of Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. He said, watch and pray that you enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. May the spirit of the Lord give us the enablement to be watchful, to be active in the spirit, to be quickened in the spirit, to stand in the spirit, so that first of all, yourself and your environment will be a stronghold of God to pull down the network of darkness. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father, I pray. I commit this ministration into your hands, Father. I pray that you use it to deliver anyone watching this program now, anyone that is under the influence of sleep wave. Let sleep wave disappear and fade away. Sleep wave disappear and fade away. Sleep will disappear and fade away from all those that believe in the Lord of the universe, who seek the light of the Almighty in Christ. And from all those that believe in the Lord, anywhere they are in this world, in any enclave, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Once again, do not forget 7 cycles of astral attack and money and how to work. We have a lot of books, but this is the only book that you can never obtain through the Amazon. We have a lot of materials, probably some very important material, but we advise you, we bring up this from time to time in here, in almost every program we are doing of recent, because we don't know the one you'll be fortunate to watch. This is the April 2020 updated version of 7 Cycles of Astral Attack on Money and How to Overcome. It is exposed on earth for the first time. Get this material, and practically, in practical terms, you will see a change that will come your way. God bless you. Amen.
Watch out for the Abijan Media Team Deep Spiritual Shelf with the Abijan of the Last Covenant.